Yes, Dean.
So I'm just here to stand up for the science, because what I heard over here on this side was a couple of theologians making a mangled mishmash of
neither
physics.
Of us are theologians. We're both philosophers, by the way.
Okay. Okay. Well, a couple of philosophers totally screwing up the physics. I wish Lawrence Krauss were here to tell you a few things.
Hello, Dr. Krauss. I know who you are. Thank you.
I'm not Dr. Krauss. But here's the thing. You know, the core of your argument was basically physics. You were saying, oh, is he here? Good. Is he gnawing? Good. Anyway, so the core of your argument was physics. The Big Bang, fine-tuning, so forth. You know, the Big Bang was determined to universal agreement among informed people by the use of evidence, mathematics, observations, things like
this. So
that
would be your preamble.
That's my preamble. Here's the question. Now, as philosophers, I would expect you to be competent in answering this one. You made this great, gigantic, logical leap from the Big Bang to claiming that it was a personal, intelligent being who caused it all. You didn't bother to mention, but his name is Jesus. Could you possibly give me any mathematical, physical, evidential reason that that is true?
I apologize to you, Dr. Krauss, by the way, for misidentifying. The claim is that we made a huge leap from the Big Bang to a personal God. It wasn't a leap. I argued through the evidence and then deductions from the evidence. The evidence tells us that the universe was shrunk down to a point of infinite density, singularity. Space-time, matter, and energy came into existence
simultaneously. Not evidence. That's an assertion. It is not an evidence.
That's exactly what Stephen Hawking and Roger Penrose showed in 1970, that those four things came into existence simultaneously. So our universe came out of nothing, literally nothing. Therefore, there must be a cause. Now, this cause, since there was no space-time, matter, or energy, must be timeless and immaterial and spaceless. The only types of entities that can be timeless or immaterial are either a transcendent personal mind or abstract objects. We know that abstract objects, though, can't cause anything. So in order to cause the universe, this cause had to be a transcendent personal mind. So that conclusion was a deduction, not a leap.
So, hang on. Well, sorry, you can applaud for him. I didn't mean to stop you from that.
I'm done.
Okay. So, I love how you keep citing physicists who don't agree with the conclusions you're drawing from their work. But what you said, and you asserted it here again, is that one of the things that can exist outside of space-time is this personal mind. I have no... I don't know, and granted, it's unfair of me to ask a question here because you're not going to get to answer it. So I'll just say, I don't see any justification for asserting that a mind can exist outside of a brain, let alone outside of space-time.